Thank you. चेंजिंग तो दे अपन दे
ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय
ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय
ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय
ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय
ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय prayers by Queen Kunti, and we're going to continue tonight. This is first canto, text number
8.
Gopya de twai pitagasi atmadabhat
Gopya de twai
Gopya de twai tragasi dhammatabhat
Gopya de twai pitagasi dhammatabhat
Yate dadashru kalilanjana sambramaksham
Yate dadashru kalilanjana sambramaksham
Yate dadashru kalilanjana sambramaksham
Yate dadashru kalilanjana sambramaksham
Vaktram niniyay vaktram Bhaktram niniya bhaya bhavanaya stitasya
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 Samam vimohayati birati yad bibeti
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 Gopya de twai kritagasi dhammatabhat
Gopya de twai kritagasi dhammatabhat
Yate dasashru kalilanjana sambramaksham
Yate dasashru kalilanjana sambramaksham
Vaktram niniya bhaya bhavanaya stitasya
Vaktram niniya bhaya bhavanaya stitasya
Samam vimohayati birati yad bibeti
Samam vimohayati birati yad bibeti
Gopya de twai kritagasi dhammatabha
Gopya de twai kritagasi dhammatabha
Yathe dasashru kalilanjana sambramaksham
Yathe dasashru kalilanjana sambramaksham
Vaktram niniya bhaya bhavanaya stitasya
Vaktram niniya bhaya bhavanaya stitasya
Samam vimohayati birati yad bibeti
Samam vimohayati birati yad bibeti
My dear Krishna, Yashoda took up a rope to bind you when you committed an offense, and your perturbed eyes overflooded with tears, which washed the mascara from your eyes. And you were afraid, though fear personified is afraid of you. This sight is bewildering to me.
亲爱的Krishna，也受到拿起了一根绳索来捆绑着你，当你做了冒犯的时候，而且你的眼睛满是泪水，这洗去了你眼睛里面的这个眼影，而且你是这么害怕，虽然呢，害怕的人格化身是害怕着你，而这个景象让我困惑。
Om Jnana Timurandasya Jnana Shalakaya Chakshur Nilipadena Tasmai Shri Gurve Namaha Vancha Kaupata Rukhishya Kripa Sindhu Vayavata Patitamam Pavane Yor Vaishnava Yor Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Adaya Gadara
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
So Queen Kunti is describing some of the bewildering pastimes which Lord Krishna presented when he was here on this planet.
所以根据皇后呢，继续在这个情况，当初像在这个地球的时候呢。 发生的景象，昆蒂皇后感到非常的迷惑。
Lord Krishna is the nephew of Queen Kunti.
Krishna 呢是昆蒂皇后的侄儿。
Kunti is the brother, well, she's the sister of Vasudeva, Vasudeva being the father of Lord Krishna.
Vasudeva 呢是 Krishna 的父亲，那这个昆蒂皇后呢是这个。
So Queen Kunti was aware of the position of Lord Krishna, that he is not an ordinary child, but he is the personality of Godhead. And you can see how she describes in this verse. She said that Lord Krishna was afraid of his mother, but fear personified is afraid of Krishna.
这边就在描述呢，就是说，Krishna呢，虽然也是被死亡害怕的化身呢所害怕的，可是这个时候Krishna自己却害怕着这个母亲Yashoda，这个手上正拿着一条绳索。
So Lord Krishna playing the part of the child of Mother Yashoda. He enjoys this wonderful relationship with his pure devotees.
So Krishna 在扮演这个角色呢，就是说他现在呢是因为奉献者，然后他扮演的就是说被这个母亲的对他的态度这个惩罚呢而感到害怕。
Mother Yashoda is the always the mother of Krishna. When Krishna comes to this world, Mother Yashoda and Nanda Maharaj, they're the ones who always play the part of the mother and father. Because Mother Yashoda has pure love for Krishna, she does not think of Krishna as the Supreme Lord. But she thinks of him simply as her child.
那也是那母亲呢，她对 Krishna 是纯粹的爱。那她扮演这个是一个母亲的角色，所以 Krishna 在这个时候呢，跟她这个关系是母子之情哈。Mother
Yashoda, as a mother, mother always has great devotion for her child.
那这个。 亚修的母亲，就是一个母亲，那一个母亲呢，对孩子总是一种奉爱。
This Zoom in case after they will.
Oh, not the part of the
Which one? 这个跳开，屏幕跳开了。
这个啊？
是吗？
对。 接头没有接好。
No, I want to switch on.
我想要关掉。
The Mother Yashoda is the pure devotee of the Lord, and she has this very intimate connection with Lord Krishna.
Yashoda 母亲呢是Krishna 的纯粹奉献者，然后她跟 Krishna 有非常亲密的关系。
Devati and Vasudev.But they are not quite on the same level as Nanda and Yashoda. Although they also enjoy parental affection for Krishna, the love which the affection which they have for Krishna is not on the level of Nanda and Yashoda.
Devaki, 他跟这个 Vasudeva 跟那个南达大君跟 Yashoda 对，虽然是父母的感情，可是他们的程度对 Krishna 的爱不像南达跟 Yashoda 那么强烈。
Devaki and Vasudeva, they worship Krishna with awe and reverence. They show great respect for Lord Krishna. Although he comes as their child, they offer prayers to him.
Vasudeva 呢跟那个Devaki 他们呢跟 Krishna 虽然是父母的感情，但是还是充满着敬畏，就像说对主对神至尊主那样的敬爱。
Vasudeva and Devaki, in their previous lives, they had done great austerities in order to get the Lord as their child.
Vasudeva and Devaki, 呢，在前世呢，他们做了很大的苦行，他们的要满足他的愿望，把 Krishna 成为他们的孩子。
And they got the benediction, the Lord who's come as their child, not once, but three times.
而且他们得到这样的祝福，就是主呢成为他们的孩子，不只是一世，而且是三世。
So although the Lord came as their child, they were not able to enjoy the childhood pastimes of Lord Krishna.
所以呢，即便是主成为他们的孩子，但是呢却无法跟他享有一起，就是说家庭父母子女这种感情。
As soon as Lord Krishna appeared in the prison house of Kamsa, he appeared there in his four-armed form, but he did not stay there for any length of time. He took the form of a child, and immediately Vasudev took him to the home of Nanda Maharaj.
所以 Krishna 呢，在这 Kamsa 的监狱里面出生了，出现的时候呢，并没有留得很久，就只是呢，很短暂的，然后跟 Devaki Vasudeva 一起，然后就被带到这个Yashoda Nanda 大君的家了。
One of the reasons why Vasudev brought Lord Krishna out.The prison house of Mathura to go to Nanda Maharaj's home was Vasudev was worried because Kamsa was ready to kill the children of Vasudev and Devaki.
这瓦斯代瓦呢，要把这个 Krishna 带到这个南达大君家里的其中一个原因，就是因为那时候 Kamsa 已经准备好要把这个孩子，就是把 Krishna 要杀了。
He had already killed the first six children of Vasudev and Devaki.
前面已经杀掉了这个他们的 Vasudeva Devaki 的六个孩子了。
And he knew that the eighth child was the one who was supposed to kill him.
而且他也知道呢第八个孩子是要来杀他的。
So Vasudev was worried for the safety of his child, so he.And when he got the opportunity to bring the child out of the house of, out of the prison of Kamsa, he took the child across the Yamuna to the home of Nanda Maharaj.
因为 Vasudeva 已经察觉到了那个这个孩子的危险，所以他即刻呢就把这孩子带出监狱，然后穿过 Yamuna 河呢带过去这个南达大君跟 Yashoda 家去。
So it appears.Like Vasudev was worried for the safety of his child.
所以看起来好像是 Vasudeva 担心着孩子的安全。
But another reason why Vasudev brought that child to the home of Nanda Maharaj was because Lord Krishna was so eager to be in the land of Vrindavan and to be with the cowherd people.And to enjoy being there with the cowherd people in the forest of Vrindavan.
刚才是一个原因，另外一个原因为什么这么快就被带到文达文呢？是因为 Krishna 非常急切的想要赶快到文达文去，而且想要跟那些牧牛童啊、文达文的居民一起。
So Vasudev and Devaki, they were denied the opportunity to bring up the child. They were kept in the prison house of Kamsa.
所以这个瓦苏代瓦就没有这样子，就是说可以带着孩子这种生活这样子。由于 Kamsa 的出现，他即刻要把这个孩子带走。
And it was Lord Krishna with Mother Yashoda.In Gokula, in the forest of Vrindavan, they're enjoying all the pastimes of childhood there.
所以呢 ，Krishna 呢就在 Gokula 跟 Yashoda 那还有很多的牧牛童们呢一起在享受在 Vrindavan 的那些小时光。
So Mother Yashoda, she, we're told this nice pastime howLord Krishna had broken the pot of yogurt and he was hiding from his mother.
我们也听到这个小儿时光，就像 Krishna 其中的一个部分呢，就是去偷这些奶油啦、酸奶啦，然后把这些罐子打破啊，这些活动。
The mother Yashoda, she had gone to take care of the milk because the milk was boiling on the stove. So Mother Yashoda had put down baby Krishna.At that time, Krishna had become angry and had broken the pot of yogurt.
那就是在喂 Krishna 奶的时候呢，这个厨房的牛奶滚出来，他就把 Krishna 放下来。那 Krishna 就是调皮的那种生气，然后故意去到储藏室，把那些装满的这个黄油啦、yogurt 这些罐子打破。
And Mother Yashoda, after taking care of the milk, taking the milk off the stove.She came back and she saw all the mess, all the broken pots and the butter and the yogurt all over the place, and no Krishna.
也是的，母亲呢，就是把这个厨房的火关掉了啦，啊，这个牛奶这个处理好，然后她过来看的时候呢，满地都是这些 yogurt 啊，酸奶那个。牛奶的，但是就是罐子破破碎碎的，但是就是没有 Krishna。
So Mother Yashoda went to look for her child, and it wasn't difficult to find him.
Yashoda 就去找这个孩子，但是要找他并不难。
Could see the footprints.
就看到地上那些小脚印。
So Mother Yashoda came looking for him, and she was carrying the stick.Which she uses for churning the butter, making the butter.
所以 Yashoda 呢，他就赶快找起，随手找到地上的一根棍子，那是他本来要做搅拌黄牛的奶油的这种棍杖。
So Lord Krishna is the supreme personality of Godhead, but he's playing the part of a child.
所以Krishna 呢，他是至尊人格首身，但是他扮演着一个孩子的这样的身份。
Whatever parts Krishna plays, he always plays them perfectly.
不管 Krishna 扮演什么样的角色，他总是非常完美的展示这个角色。
He is the perfect friend of the cowherd boy.
他是这个牧牛童的完美的朋友。
They're equals. They're all the cowherd boys are equal, and they think of themselves equal with Krishna, and they will play with Krishna just on an equal level.
那些牧牛童们呢，都是这样平等的朋友哈。那他们也把 Krishna 当作跟他们是一样这些牧牛朋友。
Sometimes they will take the prasadam, take Krishna's prasadam. Sometimes Krishna will take their prasadam.
所以他们这样平等的友谊呢，所以有时候呢，他们从 Krishna 的盘子拿 prasadam 来吃，那 Krishna 也从他们盘子去拿 prasadam 来吃。
Lord Krishna is also the perfect lover with the gopis.
Krishna 也是这个牧牛姑娘们的完美的爱人。
And when he was a house, when he was in Dwarka with all of his wives, he was a perfect husband to all of his wives.
当他在 Dwarka 的时候呢，他是那一些皇后，就是他的妻子们的完美的丈夫。
So in Vrindavan, with Mother Yashoda and Nanda Maharaj, Lord Krishna is playing the part of the child.
那 Krishna 在 Vrindavan 呢，在南达大金耶修达家，他扮演是一个小孩子的这样的身份。
And as a child, you know, children, they're usually always a little mischievous and a little naughty. They like to do things which they shouldn't do.
那我们知道了，孩子一般都是很调皮的，常常做一些我们认为不该做的事。
So Lord Krishna was just like that. He was just like any other child.
所以 Krishna 就像任何其他小孩一样的表现。
And Mother Yashoda, she's treating Krishna just like her child. She's not treating him like God.
亚瑟的母亲呢，对着Krishna 就像是跟就是自己的孩子，没有去想说他是神这样子。
Although he's the supreme Lord, he's coming as in the mood of a child. He's playing the part of the devotee of his devotee.
虽然他是至尊主，但是他扮演的是奉献者的角色，所以他也展示这样奉献者的这样情况。
Just like Lord Krishna is known as Madanmohan, the conqueror of Cupid.
就好像 Krishna 有一个名字叫 Madanmohan, 就是他是征服丘比特的人。
But he's conquered by the pure love of Srimati Radharani.
虽然他征服一切，但是他被Radharani 的爱所征服。
So Radharani is Madan Mohan Mohini, that she can conquer Krishna.
So Radharani is Madan Mohan Mohini, 就是她可以征服 Krishna.
And in the same way, we're seeing Krishna, Lord Krishna is the Supreme Lord, but he's in fear of Mother Yashoda.
但是呢，我们把 Krishna 是看成就是神，就是主，但是 Krishna 他却害怕的 Yashoda。
Mother Yashoda is coming and Krishna knows he's done a lot of mischief, he's broken all the pots, he's put butter and yogurt everywhere. So Mother Yashoda is coming looking for him.
那么Krishna 知道他自己也做了这件事呢，就是把这些酥油、奶油、yogurt 都打破了，然后他知道不该这么做，然后Yashoda看到了就知道了。
And when the child, just like when a child is mischievous, then the parents will think how to restrict him.
所以呢，就是小孩子如果说做了调皮不该做的事，这个父母亲都会想说怎么样来好好管教这个小孩，怎么样来教训管教一下。
Sometimes they'll put the child in a playpen. They will have some area.In which the child can play with a fencing around it, and the child will be inside the fence.
有时候他们会做一个游戏圈，就是只有在那个范围，小孩子只有在那个范围可以玩。
So in the villages in India, it's customary for when the child is mischievous, and to stop the child getting in too much mischief, the mother will tie the child to some.So that the child cannot go far away.
那在印度呢，他们有这样的习惯，如果小孩太皮、太过皮、管不动的时候，他们会把小孩子绑起来，绑在某一个地方，他只能在一个范围内活动而已。
Just like sometimes we see with dogs, you know, you have the dog on a leash and you won't let the dog go too far away.
就好像说你家里有狗啊乱跑乱跳，你就会用绳子只是把它限制在一个范围一个距离而已。
So Mother Yashoda is concerned about Krishna that he may go to the other gopis' homes and he may break all the pots of yogurt there in the homes of the other gopis.
所以亚瑟的母亲就想他也怕的说 Krishna 呢跑去别人的家里，跑去别人牧牛姑娘们家里去做一些调皮的事。
He may even go away far away from home. So Mother Yashoda doesn't want anything to happen to her child.
他就是说 Krishna 搞不好也会离家离得很远，然后会有什么事情发生呢？ Yashoda 他也会担心。
So Mother Yashoda had him tied.
所以 Yashoda 母亲就把他绑起来。
And Lord Krishna agreed to allow his devotee to do this to him.
而 Krishna 同意的。Krishna 允许他的奉献者这么样的对他。
This is the nature of the pure love of the devotee.
这是奉献的纯粹的爱的本质。
Because they have such great love for Krishna, Krishna becomes controlled by them.
因为他们对 Krishna 有这么大的爱，所以 Krishna 被他们所控制。
And he doesn't feel so much control for those people who are worshipping him with awe and reverence.
但是呢 ，Krishna 并不太被那所谓对他又恭敬、毕恭毕敬又害怕这样的崇拜的人所控制。
People may recite so many prayers to the Lord with great respect.
人们呢可能很极崇敬的这样去朗诵很多的祈祷文。
So they're giving all the honor and respect to Lord Krishna.
他们把所有的这一些尊崇尊敬都献给 Krishna.
But Lord Krishna takes more pleasure out of the love of the devotees who worship, who are loving him.Without all of this pomp, without all of the majesty and the veneration.
然而 Krishna 更感觉快乐是奉献者对他自然的爱胜过于那些多么尊崇多么害怕他的人。
He enjoys them treating him just like an ordinary child.
Krishna 享受的奉献者跟他的关系很自然的，就像跟人类的跟人自然的交情一样。
So Mother Yashoda was able to enjoy this wonderful exchange with Lord Krishna.
所以亚瑟达母亲呢，就是在享受跟 Krishna 这样的爱的交流的。
But it was all done without Mother Yashoda being conscious of it.
这样的发生呢，完全没有说亚瑟达特别去察觉或意会。
Mother Yashoda just thought Krishna is my child.
亚瑟达母亲只是想着，哦 ，Krishna 是我的孩子。
It's my duty to take care of him and protect him.
所以是我的责任要照顾他，保护他。
And she has so much love for Krishna.
亚瑟达对 Krishna 有这么多的爱。
When Lord Krishna left Vrindavan and left Mother Yashoda, then Mother Yashoda's eyes were always filled with tears.
当 Krishna 离开 Vrindavan 离开亚瑟达的时候，亚瑟达常常总是眼睛充满泪水。
That she went blind just by because she was crying so much in separation from her child.
就是她跟 Krishna 感到那么深的分离的感情，就一直在这边啜泣、哭泣而变得眼盲。
But Lord Mother Yashoda was able to enjoy this, the very best of the pastimes of Lord Krishna as a child.
而 Krishna 享受的跟Krishna 这样子，就是说他在孩提时候的最好的时光。
Krishna has pastimes in Dwarka, he has pastimes in Mathura, and he has pastimes in Vrindavan.
Krishna 有这么多小时光，在 Mathura, 在 Dwarka, 在 Vrindavan。
In Dwarka, Lord Krishna, of course, is married, and he has his wife there.He's playing the part of a father and a husband. And he's the ruler also of Dwarka.
Krishna 在 Dwarka 呢，他扮演的多重角色。他有结婚，是一个丈夫，也是他有孩子，是一个父亲，而且同时是一个管理统治者。
So that Krishna is perfect in Dwarka.
所以说 Krishna 在Dwarka 是完美的。
But he's more perfect in Mathura.
而在 Mathura 他是更加的完美。
In Mathura, this is the place where Lord Krishna appears. He took his birth there in Mathura.
Krishna 是在 Mathura 出现，等于是他的出生地。
And he lived there in Mathura for some time before he went to Dwarka.
而 Krishna 在去 Dwarka 之前住在 Mathura 住了一段时间。
And all the people in Mathura, especially the ladies of Mathura, they all had great love for Lord Krishna.
在Dwarka Mathura 都是这些妇女们呢，也是非常的尊重珍爱 Krishna.
It was in Mathura Lord Krishna also killed Kamsa.
而且在 Mathura 的时候 Krishna 也是把 Kamsa 杀了。
And then he freed his father and mother from the prison house of Kamsa.
然后呢把这个父母亲从 Kamsa 的监狱中解救出来。
So Lord Krishna's pastimes in Mathura are even more relishable than the pastimes in Dwarka.
所以 Krishna 在 Mathura 的逍遥时光是胜过于在 Dwarka 的逍遥时光。
But the most relishable, the most perfect of Krishna's pastimes take place in Vrindavan.
而最让人回味 ，Krishna 最想、最快乐的时光是在 Vrindavan 的。
Because in Vrindavan, he is enjoying pastimes with his very special devotees.
因为 Krishna 在 Vrindavan 呢，他享受跟他这些特别的奉献者之间的交流。
We hope.Why friends, the gopas, the cowherd boys, Lord Krishna would be with them every day in the forest.
Krishna 有他的一些那个男孩子的同伴啊，这个牧牛童啊，成日在这个森林里面啊一起游玩啊，还有跟这些牛儿玩呢。
They were all very great souls.
虽然是牧牛童，但他们都是伟大的灵魂。
They performed pious activities over many lifetimes.
他们之前是非常多生世进行了很多虔诚的活动。
And the result of all their previous pious activities is that now they're able to enjoy.Taking part in the pastimes of Lord Krishna.
他们前面生生世世的那一些虔诚活动的结果，就是让他们现在可以跟 Krishna 一起直接交流这些逍遥时光。
Sometimes the cowherd boys would be in the forest of Vrindavan, and there would be a forest fire. There would be fire all around them. The cowherd boys would not know what to. They would all come to Krishna and take shelter.
有时候在文达文那些森林里面呢，也会发生说森林的火灾。那么这些牧牛童们呢，都不知道怎么办，所以他们就来求救哈，跟 Krishna 求 Krishna 的托庇。
In Vrindavan can get very hot in the summer, very hot, very dry. So then the bamboo rubs together can create a spark, and you get a big forest fire.
在 Vrindavan 的夏天是非常热又干，所以这个树木呢，竹枝互相干燥摩擦就生火，所以就点起整个森林大火。
But when there's the forest fire, the danger, the cowherd boys, they all know, just go to Krishna, take shelter of Krishna.
这个时候呢，牧牛童们就说：“那我们赶快去找 Krishna， 我们求 Krishna 的庇护。”
So Lord Krishna told all the cowherd boys, "Just close your eyes," and all the cowherd boys closed their eyes, and then Lord Krishna swallowed the forest fire.
那 Krishna 就说：“好。”他告诉所有牧牛童说：“你们把眼睛闭起来。”然后他们都闭起来，然后 Krishna 就把这个森林大火吸到吞到嘴里去。
Just like sometimes if you read Tamal Krishna Goswami's book, Servant of the Servant, he tells about how they used to do Sankirtan in Paris, and in the streets of Paris, there used to be this one and was a fire eater.
如果有读到 Tamal Krishna Goswami 的书，就是仆人的仆人里面写到，就说他们以前常常在巴黎去派书，那路上有人在表演马戏啊、杂技啊，也有人表演那个吞火啊，那个马戏团吞火那个。
In Paris, you know, there are many different artists in the streets. Some people playing guitar and singing.And then there was this one man who was doing tricks, and one of the children was eating fire.
然后在巴黎的街头啦，也有很多街头艺人啦，有弹琴的啦，唱歌的啦，打乐器的啦，或做马戏什么。那也有一个人是演那个吞火这样的马戏。
So he could eat one little burning stick.
他就拿着一个有点火这个小棍子，这样子刮刮刮。
But Lord Krishna could swallow the whole forest fire.
那人只吞那一小根火，但是 Krishna 可以把整片森林的火都吞进去。
And another time, The Agasura demon came in Vrindavan, and the Agasura demon, you know, he's the brother of Putana. Lord Krishna had killed Putana, so Agasura came, wanted to get revenge.
有一回呢，阿甘苏拉他是普塔纳这个女魔的兄弟，然后这个阿甘苏拉他过来也要想要杀掉克什纳。
And Agasura lay there with his mouth open, and his mouth was huge. It was like a huge cave all the way up to the sky.
那阿甘苏拉就张开嘴巴，一嘴开，嘴巴一张开，整个天空就像一个很大的一个洞。
And Agasura's plan was he would just lay there with his mouth open and he would attract the cowherd boys into his mouth and then he would swallow them.
Agasura 就躺在那儿，然后嘴巴张得大大，然后他要诱拐那些牧牛童进到他嘴里，然后他想要把这些牧牛童都吞进去。
So Lord Krishna saw the Agasura demon and of course he understood that you know, this is just a demon, one of Kamsa's friends is taking this terrible form.
Krishna 很清楚知道呢，这个家伙是Kamsa 派来的另外一个恶魔，想要来给他，所以杀他。
But the cowherd boys, the other cowherd boys, they were thinking, oh, this is interesting.Let's go inside and see what's inside this cave.
因为他这个嘴巴张得很大很大，像一个大山洞。那他们牧牛童不知道，他们就说：“哦，那看起来很有趣呢，一个很大的洞，一个山洞里面可能有什么新奇的事，让我们进去看一看。”
And even if there's any danger, Krishna's here, he will protect.
同时也想说。哇，即便有任何危险的话 ，Krishna 在这儿 ，Krishna 会保护我们的。
No, they had their confidence in Krishna. Krishna's here, nothing can happen.
所以他们有那么充足的信心，就是对 Krishna 有信心，只要 Krishna 在，没有 Krishna 在，不会有任何事情发生。
So the cowherd boys all went into the mouth of the Agasura demon.
所以这些牧牛童都进到这阿嘎苏拉这个恶魔的嘴里去了。
And Krishna was thinking, oh my goodness, the cowherd boys have all gone in there. What are we going to do?
Krishna 就想，哎呀，我的天哪，我这些牧牛朋友们都进到这个恶魔的嘴里啦，他们要怎么办呢？
So Lord Krishna thought, I better also go in there and help.
Krishna 说，那我最好也一样进去这个嘴巴那个山洞里，看看可以做什么，帮他们。
And when Krishna entered into the mouth of the Agasura demon, then the Agasura demon thought, now I've got them all, now I'll swallow them.
所以 Krishna 就进到 Agasura 的嘴里去了。那 Agasura 想说，哦，现在我通通把他们抓起来了，他们当中被我吞起来了。
But Krishna expanded himself in the mouth of the Agasura demon.
而 Krishna 在 Agasura 这个恶魔的嘴里一直把自己扩大胀起来。
And he choked the demon by expanding himself. The demon.
所以他身体就在 Agasura 嘴里一直扩大，让他断气和窒息死掉。
And Krishna and all the cowherd boys came out.
这个时候呢，恶魔一死，摊开了，这个牧牛童都从这个恶魔的嘴里跑出来了。
So Krishna enjoyed all the loving dealings with the cowherd boys, and then he had also loving dealings with Nanda and Yashoda.
所以 Krishna 呢有很多跟这个牧牛童所享受的各种逍遥时光。那 Krishna 跟 Nanda 跟 Yashoda 也有很多的这个享受的逍遥时光。
And sometimes he'd do things wrong, and parents would chastise him.
然后就像一般孩子那样的行为，有时候故意做错。然后父母当然会惩罚。
But Krishna would enjoy these chastisements. This was the bliss. This is what he wanted.
但是 Krishna 在享受这样被责骂、被惩罚，因为这是父母会给的。
He wanted that pure loving relationship with his devotee.
Krishna 是想要他跟他纯粹奉献的那种爱的里面的关系。
And he just wanted to be as a child. He didn't want to be thinking that he was God.
而且他喜欢这样想，啊，我就是个孩子，而不愿意自首，说我是个神。
The Lord Krishna enjoyed this loving exchange with Mother Yashoda and Nanda Maharaj. Sometimes Nanda Maharaj will chastise Krishna and Krishna will take a humble part and he'll bring his father's shoes on his head.
那所以 Krishna 都要享受跟南达大帝跟 Yashoda 之间的爱的交流。那有些时候啊 Krishna 也是这样子的弄了调皮啊，做错一点事啊什么的，南达大军就会来责备啊，要处罚他。克夏就哇，就知道自己犯错，非常谦卑的把这个南达大军鞋子啊放在头上，然后到父亲面前就是顶拜求饶这样子。
When we come to temple, we bow to Krishna. We bow our head and we bow before Krishna.
当我们进到庙里面的时候呢，我们是头顶拜，向 Krishna 来顶拜。
But Lord Krishna would come before Nanda and Yashoda, and he would bow to them.
然而 Krishna 会到南达大吉耶稣的面前呢，向他们呢这样子去顶拜。
Play the part of the nice little child.
他扮演一个很好的孩子的这样的角色。
And of course, Lord Krishna's loving dealing would only increase the love which Mother Yashoda had for Krishna.
当然呢 ，Krishna 的这些爱的交流的活动是更增加的南达跟 Yashoda 对他的爱。
And not only Mother Yashoda loved Krishna, all the gopis in Vrindavan, all the ladies in Vrindavan, they all loved Krishna.
所以不只是南达耶修达爱着 Krishna， 在 Vrindavan 所有的人呢，牧牛姑娘、牧牛童们都是爱着 Krishna。
They all wanted Krishna as their child.
他们都想要 Krishna 变成他们的孩子。
And Krishna fulfilled their desire.
而 Krishna 也满足他们的愿望。
Lord Brahma stole away all the cows and the cowherd boys.
梵天婆罗赫摩来把这个所有的牧牛童啊、牛啊，好像都偷走了的。
So at that time, Lord Krishna expanded himself and he took the place of all the cows and all the cowherd boys.
那个时候 ，Krishna 把自己扩展出来，然后呢，代替那一些牛跟牧牛童。
And for 1 year, Lord Krishna was playing the part of all the other cowherd boys.
所以呢，整整一年的时间 ，Krishna 扮演了其他这些失落的这些牧牛童跟牛。
And all the cowherd ladies, all the gopis of Vrindavan, they were enjoying having Krishna as their child.
所有的牧牛人呐、牧牛姑娘们呢，都享受的Krishna 是自己孩子跟自己孩子的这些关系。
But they didn't actually know it was Krishna. They were thinking it was their own son.
而他们那时候并不晓得，那是 Krishna 扩展出来，他们以为是自己的小孩，不知道是 Krishna 扩展出来的。
So the person who we really love is Krishna.
所以我们真正爱的人呢是 Krishna.
That we're thinking we love this person, that person. We love our family.But actually, the person we really love is Krishna.
我们会这么认为啊，我爱这个，我爱那个，我爱谁？但实际上，我们真的爱的人是 Krishna.
It's Krishna within the heart of every living entity, which allows us to feel love for them.
因为如果 Krishna 在生物的心里面，会让这个生物感觉他对其他人、对其他生物的爱。
So Krishna enjoys this.Loving exchange. He enjoyed bowing his head to his mother and father.
So Krishna 享受着跟这些人，还现在跟南达耶修达这种爱的交流，所以他会向他们顶拜。
And sometimes Krishna would perform wonderful pastimes, like he picked up the Govardhan Hill as a 7-year-old child.
有时候呢 ，Krishna 也是进行的非常惊人、不可思议的活动。比方说，他只是一个7岁孩子，就把 Govardhan 山举起来了。
So the people, the other men in Vrindavan, they were saying to Nanda Maharaj that, you know, your son is very special. He performed these wonderful activities.
其他的牧牛人来跟南达大军讲说， 你知道吗？你的儿子非常特别，他进行的是啊非比寻常的这个活动。
Ananda Maharaj would say, "Yes, yeah, it's true what you say. He performed some amazing things, but at the same time, you don't know what a naughty child he is."
那南达巴就说。是啊是啊，他可以做出很多令人不可思议的事，可是你不知道他有时候是做出让人受不了的非常调皮的事。
Sometimes people pass you and here and there.
有时候 Krishna 那么调皮到处尿尿。
You don't know what he's doing, all the mischief he causes.
你们不知道 他有时候做出你没办法想象那些调皮的事。
But the people of the other men of Vrindavan, they say, you know, we think your son may be a demigod.
那些牧牛人说，你知道吗，我们甚至认为你的儿子呢是半神人。
And of course, at the time of the name giving ceremony of Lord Krishna, at that time, Gargataria,had already warned Nanda Maharaj.
当 Krishna 出生后不久要接受命名那个仪式呢，这个 Gargacharya 他来的时候就已经向南达大军先跟他警告了。
Actually, Vasudev had arranged for Gargacharya to go to the home of Nanda Maharaj and give the names of the two children.
实际上是 Vasudeva他安排 Gargacharya 去到南达大君家里来帮 Krishna 命名。
Mother Yashoda had given birth to Lord Krishna, and Rohini had given birth to Lord Balaram, and they needed to have the name-giving ceremony.
所以啊 ，Yashoda 就是生出 Krishna， 然后 Rohini 生出了 Balaram， 所以这两个孩子出来了，当然要给他们命名。
So at that time, Gargacharya came there and he told to Nanda Maharaj that this child, he has taken birth in different ages in different colors.
那刚刚查尔来到南达大君家里的时候，然后跟南达大君家里说，你这个孩子啊，在过去很多个年代都有出现过。
In the Satya Yuga, he came in the white color.
在 Satya 年代，他以白色的肤色身体出现。
And then the Treta Yuga, he came in the red color.
在特塔年代呢，他肤色以红色这样出现。
And now he's come in this blackish color.
而现在他身体的是天然黝黑那个颜色。
And he also come in yellow.
然后呢，之后也会出现为这个金黄肤色。
And this child will be almost like Narayan himself.
而这个孩子基本上就差不多就是 Narayan 他本人了。
And Gargacharya warned Nanda Maharaj, there will be many dangers will come.
这个 Gargacharya 就对南达大君说。之后会发生很多危险的事。
But this child will overcome all the danger.
即便非常多的危险发生，但是这个孩子会克服所有的危险。
And of course it happened. So many the friends, the supporters of Kamsa, they came in many different forms trying to kill Krishna.
当然啦，这个发生就是说 Kamsa 用很多方式来进行，然后就是计划着怎么样杀掉 Krishna 的事。
But one by one, Lord Krishna killed all of them.
虽然这样的，但是一个一个都被 Krishna 所征服所杀掉。
So finally, of course, Kamsa sent Akrura to come to Vrindavan and Lord Krishna.
那最后呢 ，Kamsa 就派的 Akura 去 Vrindavan 要把 Krishna 带去 Mathura.
So this was the end of Lord Krishna's childhood pastimes in Vrindavan.
所以这个时候就是 Krishna 在 Vrindavan 的孩提笑时光一个结束。
The most wonderful pastimes of Krishna.
这段时光是 Krishna 的笑时光，最棒、最奇妙的。
And of course, the most very special of all the dealings of Krishna was Krishna's dealings with the gopis of Vrindavan.
然后在 Krishna 很多的交流活动之中呢，跟牧牛姑娘们的交流是最特别的。
Just as the cowherd boys were very special souls, they had performed pious activities over many lifetimes, so also the gopis were not ordinary.
就像那些牧牛童们，他们是很多生生世世从事了很多的虔诚的活动。那同样的牧牛姑娘们也是一样，经过那么多生世的虔诚苦行。
There are different groups of gopis who take part in Lord Krishna's pastime.
然后牧牛姑娘们也有很多个小组，然后他们在进行 Krishna 的逍遥时光。
Some gopis, they are coming from the spiritual world. They're coming with Krishna to take part in this pastime.
有一些牧牛姑娘是直接从灵性世界而来的，而直接参与 Krishna 的逍遥时光。
And some gopis have just become perfect, and they're just getting ready to go back to Godhead.
而有一些牧牛姑娘是在这个星球上变得完美，而回到灵性世界去。
They're taking part in Lord Krishna's pastimes in this earthly abode.Before they go back to the spiritual world.
就是他们在回到灵性世界之前，先在这个地球的这个跟 Krishna 参与逍遥时光之后的完美，再回到灵性世界。
Then there are other gopis who, in their previous life, they were all great sages in the forest of Dandakaranya.
那还有另外一些牧牛姑娘们，她们是圣人，在丹丹卡拉尼亚那个地，那个圣地。
And as great sages, they had met Lord Ramachandra during his exile in the forest.
也有一些伟大的圣人是在祖 Ram 被放逐，到森林放逐那时候遇到了祖 Ram。
Lord Ramachandra had been sent to forest by the.Desire the instruction of his father.
那时候当然 Ramachandra 是受了父亲的这个训示而去到森林里面去放逐。
So there were many great sages living in the forest, and when they saw Lord Ramachandra, they were attracted to him, and they desired to enjoy an amorous, loving relationship.
那时候呢，当然在森林里面很多的圣人，那虽然是在祖 Ram 的时代，但是那时候他们见到的 Krishna 在森林里面见到 Krishna 被 Krishna 的美所吸引，所以他们就有这个愿望来参与 Krishna 跟 Krishna 那种亲爱的爱情的交流。
Lord Krishna told them, of course, in the form of Lord Ramachandra, he had taken a vow.Only have one wife.
当然在 Ramachandra 的逍遥时光里面只有立誓过，我只要有一个老婆，我一世只一个。
So he told them, you come in my next incarnation, you take birth in the family of the cowherd people in Vrindavan.
所以他就告诉他们说，那么你们要跟我享受爱的关系的话，你们就在下一次我出现的时候，你们投生于这些牧牛人的家里，成为他们的孩子，然后跟我有这个爱的交流。
So one group of gopis, they were great sages from the Dandakaranya forest during the time of Lord Ramachandra.
所以有一群牧牛姑娘，她们是以前在 Ramachandra 的时候，在 Dandakaranya 这个森林里面的圣人。
And another group of gopis are the personified Vedas.
然后还有另外一组牧牛姑娘们，她们是韦达经典的人格化身。
The personified Vedas, they wanted to understand the loving dealings of the personality.
这些伟达经典的人格化身，他们想要来了解，就是说在伟达经典真理里面的人格至尊主的爱的关系的交流。
Just simply by the Vedic knowledge, it's very difficult to know Lord Krishna.
如果单单只是伟达的知识的话，是很难了解 Krishna 的。
It's stated by Lord Brahma in the Brahma Samhita.He says, Vedeshu Durlabham, very difficult to know Krishna through the Vedas. 嗯，
所以在婆罗河摩赞的巴玛萨米塔梵天赞里面有叙述 ，Vedic Sulabha 就说很难来了解 Krishna。
So the personified Vedas wanted to understand Lord Krishna, and they were instructed they should take birth in the family of the cowherd people in Vrindavan.
嗯，所以呢，他们就得到这个训示，然后出现在文达本，成为像牧牛童啊，这样跟 Krishna 的这些交流。
And in this way, different groups of gopis were all there.
嗯，所以像这样各种不同组别的牧牛姑娘们就在文达本。
And these gopis all have the highest love for Krishna.
嗯，而且这些牧牛姑娘们都对 Krishna 有最高最崇高的爱。
Their love is so great that they will sacrifice everything for the pleasure of Krishna.
那他们的爱是那么伟大，他们愿意为 Krishna 牺牲所有的一切。
But they do not care about their own happiness.
他们就不会管个人的快乐与否。
They only think about what will make Krishna happy.
他们所想的只是想要让 Krishna 快乐。
And they're willing to do everything and anything for the pleasure of Krishna.
而且他们非常的愿意为 Krishna 做任何的事。
And so Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appreciated.The gopis of Vrindavan express the highest love of Krishna.
所以主持人妈妈不就在传扬这个对主最高的爱啊，对 Krishna 的爱。
And Lord Krishna loved the gopis also.
嗯 ，Krishna 也爱着牧牛姑娘们。
That they gave everything to Krishna. Krishna told the gopis, he said, you've given so much to me. He said, I cannot repay you for what you've given.
Krishna 对牧牛姑娘们说，你们把所有一切都献给我了，那我真的不知道用什么来回报你们。
And he encouraged them, you have to be satisfied with your own loving feelings.
而且也告诉他们，那你们就只要满足于你们可以有着爱的关系，你的交流。
So this is a mode of the devotee.
所以这是奉献者的心态。
Lord Krishna cannot repay for what you're doing for him.
Krishna 无法回报你所对他的奉献。
You have to be satisfied with your own activity.
而你只要满足于你自己的活动。
Then you're dedicating everything for the pleasure of Krishna.
满足于你对 Krishna 所做出的付出奉献。
So in this way, Queen Kunti is offering prayers to Lord Krishna.
所以像这样的方式，这样的态度呢，昆蒂皇后在向 Krishna 献上祈祷。
How he is bewildering everyone by this wonderful different pastime.
就描述的就是说。Krishna 是怎么样的迷惑的一切生物，就是因为 Krishna 进行这么美妙的逍遥时光。
Are there any questions?
到此各位有没有问题？任何提问？
你靠近一点嘛。我想问，就是如果康萨知道是第八个小孩要杀掉他的话，那干嘛要杀前六个？没有必要。
If Kamsa knew only the eighth child would kill him, why he had to kill the other six?
Yeah, because he was encouraged by the other demons.
因为 Krishna 受到其他恶魔的蛊惑。
But you know, don't take the chance.
所以不要去冒险投机。你不要投机。
Yeah, that They may say the eighth child is going to kill you, but if the eighth child could kill you, then any of the other children, they could also kill you.
恶魔都想，如果第八个能杀了你，那其他的也都有可能把你杀了。
So, Kamsa was that kind of demon. He was a very evil person that he had killed a lot of children.
Kamsa 是这么邪恶的恶魔，他斩草除根，所有都想把他杀掉。
When the omen was told.After the omen was told, then Kamsa sent his people around. He sent them everywhere to kill all the young children who were born at that time.
Oh, because when he heard the prophecy, that the eighth child was going to kill him, he was afraid. He even sent his people to all the children to kill all the children.
But what happened was that.The people, the agents of Kamsa, they would kill the children of all the demons.
They killed all the children
of the demons.
但是呢，那个啊，康萨派人去要杀掉所有的小孩，可是这一些派出去人只杀掉恶魔的小孩。
Krishna protects the devotees.
所以是 Krishna 在保护他的奉献者。
The six children who were killed by Kamsa, later on, Lord Krishna brought them back to life.
而且说到呢，啊，先前的孩子呢，六个孩子被 Kamsa 所杀的呢，后来 Krishna 都让他们起死回生。
So Lord Krishna could do these wonderful activities.
所以 Krishna 可以，做这。
Krishna.Can you bring back your brothers? Because Kamsa killed all your brothers, so can you bring them back?
因为呢，Krishna 都把他的老师的儿子都救起死回生了，所以Yashoda母亲就说，你都可以把你老师的儿子救活了，那你可不可以把你前面的这一些哥哥们的，就是把他们同样救活，起死回生
？So Lord Krishna brought them back.He went to Yamaloka, the god of death, and he brought them back from Yamaraj.
所以呢 ，Krishna 就这样去到阎罗殿，到阎罗王面前去跟他说，然后把他前面六个哥哥都带回来，起死回生。
And Mother Devaki was so happy that her children had all come again that she wanted to breastfeed them.
那Devaki 呢，他也很高兴，就说他那些死去的孩子都起死回生了，所以他又想说亲自跟他们喂奶。
Now she'd already offered her breast milk to Krishna some time ago.
而他自己之前的时候就已经亲自自己的母奶喂了这个 Krishna 了。
So her breast milk was now prasada.
所以他现在他自己的奶呢，就是 prasadam 了。
So the six children all came and they took the breast milk from Devaki. They all took the prasadam and they all became purified and they went to the heavenly planet.
那这个六个起死回生的孩子呢，现在就是喝着 Devaki 的奶啊，就是等于就是 prasadam。那他们知道喝到这个 prasadam 奶呢，那也得到完全的净化，而回到了天堂星宿。
They were all demigods who had been cursed.
那六个呢，先前都是半神人，是被受了诅咒的。
And the curse was that they would take birth in the womb of Devaki and be killed by Kamsa.
他们之前就是被诅咒，会投生于 Devaki 的胎中，然后呢，出生会被 Kamsa 所杀。
So Kamsa, he didn't know about the curse, of course, but still it came to effect.
Kamsa 当然不知道那个诅咒的部分，但是这个情况就是让他去杀掉这六个孩子。
So after they were killed, they were brought back to life by Krishna, and then they went back to the heavenly planet.
所以这六个人呢，就是说这样子的出生，然后被 Kamsa 所杀，然后又被 Krishna 救起来，然后再回到天堂星球。
Maharaj, you said there's one group of gopis who were personified by Krishna. Vedas, so did they get some benediction to be born as gopis, or is there any pastime?
他想问就是说刚刚说有一组牧牛姑娘是伟大经典的人格化身，那这些牧牛姑娘是有得到什么祝福可以成为牧牛姑娘？
Well, they wanted to actually enter into Krishna's Rasa Lila.
实际上他们是想要进入 Krishna 的 Rasa 舞蹈。
And they tried to do it just simply coming as personified Vedas.
他们为了要可以这样参与，所以他们出现为韦达经典的人格化身。
But they were told that you want to take part in Krishna's Rasa dance, you have to take birth in the family of the gopis.
有一个情况就是说，如果你要参与 Krishna 的 Rasa 舞蹈的话，你必须出生于一个牧牛姑娘的家庭。
So the personified Vedas all took birth in the family of the cowherd people, then became gopis.
所以这伟达经典的化身这些人呢，他们就投生于这个牧牛人的家里，成为这些牧牛姑娘们。
And then they could take part in Krishna's Rasa.
这样子他们就可以来参与 Krishna 的 Rasa 舞蹈。
Пожалуйста, вот пастушки, они же не знали, что Кришна это верховная личность Бога. А почему они вот так вот доверяли свою жизнь, всегда просили помощи, да, защиты у Кришны?
Thank you so much for the class. Madhuji is asking, cowboys, they don't know that Krishna is a supreme personality of Godhead. Why they trust him in these difficulties and all troubles? Because they don't know that he's God.
所以马太继续说到，那些牧牛童们不知道 Krishna 就是至尊人格首身，那他们为什么有这样的信心去信任 Krishna 可以来保护他们，可以救他们？
Because they have so much love for Krishna, pure love.
因为他们有那么多的爱，是纯粹的爱，对 Krishna 纯粹的爱。
Just like a little child will have so much love for their mother.
就像一个小孩对母亲有很多的爱。
Why does a little child have so much love for the mother?
为什么一个小小孩对妈妈有很大的爱？
It's natural.
是一种自然本能。
The mother has been caring for the child, nursing the child, so the child becomes deeply attached to the mother.
因为母亲呢，对小孩非常亲爱，无微不顾的照顾，所以小孩变得很自然，很依附，很依恋这个母亲，很依赖母亲。
So the same way, these cowherd boys have grown up with Krishna. They've been with Krishna, playing with Krishna. And they just have so much love for Krishna.
那这些牧牛童们跟 Krishna 一起玩，一起长大，所以跟 Krishna 之间也有很多的感情。
I was saying also the person who we really love is Krishna.
就像我们说到，我们人们真正爱的人，真正爱的对象是 Krishna.
So these cowherd boys, they perform many pious activities over many lifetimes.
所以那些牧牛童们，他们是很多生世的做了虔诚的活动、苦行等等。
And therefore, they're able to be with Krishna and to enjoy the pastimes with Krishna.
因为过去的那一些虔诚苦行，一直的累积，所以他们才有。这个时候有机会跟 Krishna 一起参与享受享乐时光。所以他们对 Krishna 有那么深的执着眷恋。
He's their very, very best friend.
Krishna 是他们
Every morning they'll go to Mother Yashoda's house and they will help to dress Krishna.
牧牛同伴每天早上会去到亚修达家里，然后进去帮忙Krishna打扮。
They will enjoy, they cannot bear to be separated from Krishna.
他们享受跟Krishna在一起的时光，无法忍受跟Krishna分离的这种感觉。
Always with Krishna, wherever he goes, they want to be with him.
他们呢？ 随时随地都跟Krishna在一起，不管Krishna做了什么，他们不愿意分开。
Even as children, you know, we have the experience. There will be somebody who's the leader.
就像小孩子一起玩，也会自然有一个人是带头。
Somebody who is like the, you know, the best.
一群孩子玩，也有一个孩子王，一个带头，最好的。
He's the most courageous. He's the star of everything.
可能就是哪一个小孩最勇敢啊，最棒啊，就是什么什么之心啊，拳王啊，爬墙。所以这就是Krishna.
And the cowherd boys, they have that feeling.
牧牛同们有这样的感情，对Krishna有这样的感情感觉存在。
The gopis have the feeling for Krishna, and the cowherd boys, they also have the feeling for Krishna.
牧牛姑娘们对Krishna还是有感觉、有感情的，牧牛同也是。
And the older gopis, Nanda and Yashoda and all the cowherd, they're also in love with Krishna.
那年纪比较长的牧牛姑娘、牧牛人呐、南达大金、亚修达，他们对Krishna一样也是有感情的。
The Yoga Maya.
他们受的这个影响是 Yoga Maya.
Dasya, Sakya, Vatsalya, Madhurya, the different rasas.
所以在不管是中性的、是仆人的、是朋友的、是爱你的、父母之情，这一切呢，都是 Yoga Maya 所在进行的。
So in Vrindavan, the Yoga Maya is very powerful. All the devotees, all the people in Vrindavan, they're under that spell of Yoga Maya.
所以呢 ，Yoga Maya 在 Vrindavan 是非常浓烈的、非常强的，所以在 Vrindavan 的一切的进行都弥漫在 Yoga Maya 的能量里。That
covers up Krishna for being God. That reveals him in one of the rasas.
所以在某一种的 rasa 关系里面 ，Krishna 会跟这一群奉献者之间把 Krishna 的某一个身份掩盖起来，而只展示那个部分。
And this is what's giving so much pleasure to Krishna.
那这给予 Krishna 很多很大很多的快乐。 Yugala Rasika Gudeva， 请接受我的鞠躬。如果 Krishna 非常喜欢儿童游戏，为什么他只在物质世界安排这些游戏呢？为什么他不在灵性世界安排儿童游戏 ？Very interesting. Obeisance to Gurudev. If Krishna liked the childhood pastime, why he only arrange this pastime in the earthly planet, but not in spiritual world.
Well, that's the preliminary to the pastime.
在这个孩提夏时光之前，有一些前提。
Krishna enjoys even more the other pastimes.
Krishna 在其他的逍遥时光里面更多的快乐，也享受好像自己长大的那种感觉。
Grow to a certain point and then want to stop.
但是他们想要长大，长大，长到一个点，然后不想再长大了。 Too much trouble.
When you're very young, you want to grow. You can't wait to be older. You want to be older.
那还。 Once
you get to 16 or 18, okay, that's enough.
So
that's how Krishna is. Krishna doesn't get any older. He's Nava Yovana, he's eternally
youthful.
We would all like to be Nava Yovana. Krishna has hit us.
Yashoda and Nanda Maharaj in the spiritual world, what they are doing, what they have been doing. And because in the spiritual world, there is no childish scam. The Chinese word.
No childish game.
Yeah, you use 幼稚的游戏.
幼稚. In the spiritual
the person used that word.
Okay. Childish game. Well, Nanda and Yashoda, what are they doing in the spiritual world? They're Krishna's mother and father. And they're making arrangements for Krishna. Mother Yashoda has to prepare the lunchbox for Krishna to go to the forest every day. And Nanda Maharaj has to take care of the cows, make sure the cows are all being looked after.
那么，南达大帝也同时要照顾很多的牛啊，这些牛才能好好的这样子被照顾着。So
they enjoy. They enjoy Krishna's pastime.
所以他们也是在进行各种活动的里面，享受着 Krishna 的逍遥时光.
Every day Krishna will get up and go to the forest for the cows, and in the evening he'll come home.
早上呢，Krishna起来，每天呢都会起来跟这些带着这牛儿去外面啊游耍啊，然后晚上黄昏又回来啊，带着牛一起回来啊。 所以就是这一类，就像我们一般认为的家庭时光一样。 请问奉爱的最高境界是在分离的状态下为Krishna做服务，即我们服务Guru的训示也是为Krishna做服务吗？
Yes.
Yes. Yeah. The topmost service in the mode of separation, and while we serving Guru's instruction, is also serving Krishna. Yes. 是的。
Yeah, the Guru is representing Krishna, that his instructions are...
是的，Guru就是Krishna的代表， 所以Guru的训示也是代表Krishna， 服务他的训示也是在服务Krishna。 Vrindavanadasa. Hare Krishna, Dimbai Guru的莲花族, 请问牧牛姑娘、牧牛童的父母与 Krishna 是什么爱的关系? Obeisance to Guru's lotus feet. The Gopi and Gopal, the parents of Gopi and Gopal's relationship with Krishna, what their relationship with Krishna? We stay individual, but now relate to Gopi and Gopal's parents.
Well, the cowherd boys, they're friends of Krishna.
那些牧牛童是 Krishna 的朋友.
And the gopis, they're lovers of Krishna.
牧牛姑娘们是 Krishna 的爱人爱侣.
Conjugal.
是那个爱侣之间的关系.
Kriya Post.
拜敬爱的 Gurudev， 据说幸运女神和 Lakshmi 都没有资格参加 Krishna 的 Rasa 舞蹈，那么奉献者的修行到什么程度才有可能参加 Rasa 之舞？我们是 Gurudev。It is said even the goddess of fortune cannot participate Krishna Rasa Lila. And what about us? To which level we can be qualified enter Rasa Lila?
Well, you have to become a gopi in Vrindavan.
先成为 Vrindavan 的牧牛姑娘.
Birth in the family of the cowherd people.
出生在这些牧牛人的家里.
Collect the cow dung patties.
你要去采牛粪, 然后做成牛粪饼, 做那个木材, 做那个烧火制材. Yes.
Okay, Hare Krishna. Thank you.